This tutorial explains how to work with the Sheeting Check program, which is used to analyze all types of retaining walls. For example, a pile wall, a sheet pile wall, a diaphragm wall, or a soldier pile wall, both anchored and non-anchored. We will start by inputting the geological profile. This was already shown in previous tutorials, so we will now only paste our data from the clipboard. An important factor when performing an analysis using the method of dependent pressure is the modulus of subsoil reaction. In our example, we will choose the calculation of this modulus according to Schmidt's theory, which determines it from the deformation parameters of soils and structure stiffness. Next, we input the geometry of the structure. We suggest a rectangular wall from reinforced concrete with a cross-section width of 0.3 meters. The wall will be 8 meters long. The program requires us to model the construction step by step, the same way it will be built on a real construction site. At first, we will input an excavation to the depth of 2 meters. Then we will input the terrain behind the structure. We will not input water because there is none in our location. Next, we will input the surcharge. The anchors will be modeled in the next construction stages. We run the calculation. The program calculated the deformation of the wall, which is shown in red. The blue lines show the real pressure acting on the structure from the front and from the back. The green dashed lines show the limit pressures, the active pressure, the pressure at rest, and the passive pressure. Next, we add a new construction stage. In this stage, the first row of anchors will be modeled. Its depth will be 1.5 meters. We expect its free length to be 6 meters, root length will be 3 meters, and its inclination will be 15 degrees. We will also input the pre-stressing force. In this construction stage, the anchor will act as a force. Its stiffness will come into the model in the next construction stages. After adding the anchor, we will perform the calculation again. We can see that due to the pre-stressed anchor, the structure is pushed back into the soil. However, the structure is still being deformed towards the excavation. The values of active pressure around the anchor have changed to values in between the pressure at rest and the passive pressure. This is one of the main advantages of the Sheeting Check program. The pressures acting on the structure always follow its deformation. Another construction stage can now be added. In this stage, we will do an excavation of 4.7 meters. After performing the calculation, we can see that the deformation of the wall is now higher. The force in the anchor has changed to 91 kN. On the screen, we can also see the deformation in the head of the anchor, which is 3.9 mm. Next, we add a new construction stage. We will add a new row of anchors in the depth of 4 meters with a free length of 5 meters, root length of 3 meters, inclination of 20 degrees, and force of 70 kN, and run the analysis. Now we will add the last construction stage and finish our excavation, which reaches the depth of 6.5 meters. After performing the analysis, we can see the final deformation of our retaining wall and the final forces in the anchors. If we want to know the internal forces, we can switch the display mode. Here we can see the distribution of bending moment and the shear force. We can also see the deformation of the structure and the total pressure acting on the structure. In the next frame, we can analyze the internal stability of the anchor system, which, as we see, has a safety factor of 1.62 for the upper row and 2.1 for the lower row. Both rows are satisfactory. Next, we will check the global stability in the slope stability program. The program can automatically find the worst possible slip surface and use it in the analysis. The final step is to check the cross-section of the sheet pile and design the reinforcement. On the screen, we can see envelopes of bending moments and shear forces from the results of all construction stages. Here we can see that the designed concrete cross-section is satisfactory using a reinforcement with a 6 bars profile of 22 mm per meter. This cross-section is also satisfactory for crack width check. The design and analysis of a diaphragm wall anchored in two rows is now complete. More information can be found in other video tutorials, online help, engineering manuals, and verification manuals. Should you have any questions, please contact our support team.